Hi bachcho, very good evening. Welcome back to HashLearn. My name is Aman Kumar. I am your physics faculty for JEE and NEET. Yeah, I am waiting for a few comments. Then I will start today's session that is very important for today's class. That is problems on calorimetry. ठीक है? आज की class बहुत important है and बहुत easy topic है. If you will understand this topic, you can easily score like 4 or 5 marks easily. So this topic is very important. Yeah, I am getting comment from Ankit. Very good evening. I will wait for few more comments. Then I will start today's session. Okay? So till now only I am getting comment from Ankit, few more comments. Okay, fine. So let's have a quick recap of the previous topic, what we have done in the previous class. Okay, so in the previous topic, previous class, we discuss about the introduction of internal energy, then we discuss about the specific heat capacity. That is specific heat capacity is the heat required to change the temperature of unit mass by 1 degree Celsius. That is called specific heat capacity. Types of specific heat capacity, that is specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume, that is Cp and Cv, right? Then we discuss molar heat capacity, that is heat required to change the temperature of unit mole. Heat required to change the temperature of unit mole by 1 degree Celsius. Then we discuss about the thermal capacity, then water equivalent. Okay, let's have a goal of the today class. But before that one, let me discuss one question from the previous CPP that is very important. And most of you have done the mistake in that previous CPP. Okay, it is coming on a screen. It is here now. See what is given. A hammer of mass 1 kg having speed of 50 meter per second. Heat a iron nail of mass 200 gram. If specific heat of iron is this one and half the energy is converted into heat, the raise in temperature of nail is. Ab dekho, see here what is happening. This hammer is moving with a speed of 50 meter per second. So this kinetic energy will convert into this heat energy, or here given that ki half of the energy is converted into heat. In that case, I can say that this mc delta t equal to half of kinetic energy, right? So here, and here, see here, this this specific heat is given in terms of calorie per gram. So you have to convert into this joule per kg. So here I will write this J term. What is J? J is the conversion of 1 calorie into joule. That is, you have to multiply by the 4.2. That is the 1 calorie equal to 4.2 joule. So here we will get half of half mv square equal to j mc dt. So from here you can find the value of d theta, that is 7.1 degree Celsius. Yeah, I am getting comment from Rajan. Very good evening. Kya hal chal bachche? So here 1 by 4 into 1 into 50 square, that is the speed of 50 meter per second. That is equal to 4.2 200, that is the mass of this iron nail, into 0.105 into delta theta, that is the, and you will get delta theta, that is the change in temperature, that is equal to 7.1 degree Celsius. Understood everyone? Now let's have a goal of the today class, that is also very important. So in today class, I am going to discuss about heat of transformation, latent heat. Actually both are same, there is just a difference of meaning. Actually heat of transformation and latent heat, both will be the same meaning only. Okay, heat of evaporation, heat of sublimation, principle of calorimetry, then problem. So mainly today the important part is this principle of calorimetry and heat of transformation. Okay, these three are very important for this JEE and NEET topic, because most of the question from this calorimetry will come from this topic, that is principle of calorimetry. In this topic there is the application of heat of transformation, latent heat, heat of evaporation, everything, but the important part is this principle of calorimetry. Okay, I'm good, Rajan. Chalo, so let's discuss first topic, that is heat of transformation. So, dekho, in the last class, in the previous class, I told you that whenever we increase the, or whenever we provide the heat to any body, or whenever this body will release heat, its temperature will increase or temperature will decrease. Bataya tha maine ki dekho, agar maan lo, if there is a one body here, suppose it having an energy of 20 joule, this is the heat energy. Agar isne yahan se 10 joule ko release kar diya, in that case, अगर टेम्परेचर जैसे हियर 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस, तो आफ्टर रिलीजिंग ऑफ 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस वी कैन अस्यूम दैट हियर हीट इज 10 जूल एंड टेम्परेचर विल बी 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर, व्हेनेवर वी रिलीज हीट फ्रॉम द बॉडी इज टेम्परेचर विल डिक्रीज, एंड व्हेनेवर वी प्रोवाइड हीट टू द बॉडी इज टेम्परेचर विल इंक्रीज. और मैंने एक बात और भी बोला था कि इस टेम्परेचर, व्हेनेवर यू प्रोवाइड हीट और बॉडी विल रिलीज हीट, इन दैट केस सम टाइम इस टेम्परेचर विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट. Temperature is not, it is not necessary that it will decrease or increase the temperature when you provide the heat to the body. Kaise? Agar maan lo yahan pe, if this is a body here, and suppose this is ice at 0 degree Celsius. Understood? Agar yahan pe aapne kuch amount of heat provide kiya, in that case what will happen? After some time it will come to the water at 0 degree Celsius. So here what is happening? Here only the changing of state here. Temperature is not changing, temperature is constant, and this heat is known as heat of transformation, because that heat is required to change the state of substance, change state of body here, or even say any particle, any body, any substance. Let's take an example of water here. So what is the melting point of water? It is 0 degree Celsius, and boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. So agar ab 0 degree Celsius pe, this water will be in the form of ice as well as in the form of liquid. Or you can say that water will be at 0 degree, it can at the, in the form of solid, or it can be in the form of liquid here, right? So agar maan lo there is a ice here having a temperature of 0 degree Celsius, to agar aapko isko water mein convert karna hai, in that case you have to provide some amount of heat to the water, or some amount of water some amount of heat to the ice. In that case, this heat, the heat which is changing the state of ice from solid water from solid to liquid, is known as heat of transformation, or it is also known as latent heat. It is also known as latent heat. Okay, so what is the definition of this latent heat? Heat required to change the unit mass of substance from one state to another state. Heat required to change the state of unit mass from the amount of heat required to change the state of unit mass of substance at a constant temperature is known as latent heat. देखो basically definition कुछ रखा हुआ नहीं है, देखो इतना बस याद रखोगे कि जो भी अगर heat आप दोगे, the minimum amount of heat required to change the state of substance is known as latent heat at constant temperature. The minimum amount of heat required to change the state of object at constant temperature is known as heat of transformation or latent heat. Here we are talking about the unit mass. Okay, अब देखो यहाँ पे अगर बात करते हैं, just call ended. Okay, what is happening? Okay, fine. देखो यहाँ पे अगर हम बात करें कि there is, suppose there is one body here, and here we are providing a heat of Q amount of heat to this body M. Okay, and because of this Q amount of heat, this body is changing its state from solid to liquid or liquid to solid. But just assume that because of this Q amount of heat, this mass or this body having mass m is changing its state. We can say that Q amount of heat is required to change the state of mkg of substance. ठीक है, तो कहने से, and what is latent heat? Just assume that L is the latent heat. Okay, so what is the definition of latent heat? Heat required to change the state of unit mass. Heat required to change the state of unit mass. In that case, I can say that L equal to Q upon M. What is Q? Q is the amount of heat required to change the mkg of substance, or to change the state of mkg of substance at constant temperature. So here I can say L equal to Q by M. So Q equal to M into L, Q equal to M into L, or L equal to Q by M. And what is the unit of this one? What is the unit of latent heat or heat of transformation? Here I can say that unit of heat of transformation is calorie per gram or joule per kc. And what is the dimension of this one? If we talk about the dimension of this latent heat, we can say that कभी कभी एग्जाम में आया हुआ है, नीट एग्जाम में पूछा हुआ है, एल इक्वल टू, अब देखो यहाँ पे हीट इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी, एनर्जी पर यूनिट मास, तो आई कैन से दैट एम एल स्क्वायर टी माइनस टू पर यूनिट मास हियर, बिकॉज द डायमेंशन ऑफ हीट इज एम एल स्क्वायर टी माइनस टू डिवाइड बाई एम, सो यू विल गेट एल स्क्वायर टी माइनस टू. दिस इज द डायमेंशन ऑफ लेटेंट हीट. ओके, अब चलो यहाँ पे देर इज अ फ्यू अदर फॉर्म ऑफ लाइक हीट ऑफ इवेपोरेशन और हीट ऑफ सब्लिमेशन. सो व्हाट इज द हीट ऑफ इवेपोरेशन? द मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ सॉलिड, चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ सब्सटेंस फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू लिक्विड. यस, sorry, it is the minimum amount of heat required to change the state of substance from liquid to vapor. That is called heat of evaporation. Heat of evaporation. That is heat required change the state of from liquid to vapor. Okay, and heat of sublimation kya hoga? Dekho, wahan pe hoga ki the minimum amount of heat required to change the substance from its solid to vapor state directly. Dekho, the minimum amount of heat required to change it directly into gaseous phase from its solid phase. From its सॉलिड फेज दैट इज कॉल्ड हीट ऑफ सब्लिमेशन, कि वहां पे तुम डायरेक्टली सॉलिड फेज से वहां पे इसको गैसेस फेज में चेंज कर दो, दिस हीट इज नोन एज हीट ऑफ सब्लिमेशन. फॉर एग्जांपल सपोज अगर मुझे आइस है, इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द आइस, फ्रॉम आइस टू वेपर, तो यहां पे जो हीट रिक्वायर्ड होगा दैट इज नोन एज हीट ऑफ सब्लिमेशन, हीट ऑफ सब्लिमेशन. देवी वेरी गुड इवनिंग अगेन, यू आर लेट टूडे. ओके आई थॉट, ओके आई अंडरस्टूड दैट यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम कॉलेज, राइट? Fine, no problem, Devi. Just go through once again my previous like video, like whatever you missed in today class. So heat of evaporation is minimum amount of heat required to change the state of substance from its liquid state to gaseous phase, or gaseous state or vapor state. Okay, you can say that liquid to gaseous, not vapor. Okay, gaseous phase you can say. And heat of sublimation is the minimum amount of heat required to change its state from solid to directly into gaseous phase, that is called heat of sublimation. Okay, now let's talk about the principle of calorimetry. That is a very easy topic actually. So, yahan pe ek baat clear ho gaya ki ab agar maan lo yahan pe there are two bodies here. Okay, now suppose that this body having, suppose this is A and this is B, and here its temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, here it is 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस. अगर मान लो यहां पे मैंने इनको कॉन्टैक्ट में कर दिया, व्हाट विल हैपन, टेल मी, हीट विल फ्लो फ्रॉम द ए टू बी और बी टू ए, यू गाइस विल टेल मी व्हाट इज आंसर हियर. इफ आई एम जस्ट कनेक्टिंग दिस बॉडी ए एंड बी, व्हाट विल हैपन, हीट विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी और बी टू ए, टेल मी, आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर योर कमेंट्स. देखो यहां पे जिसका जिस बॉडी का टेम्परेचर ज्यादा होगा वहां से हीट फ्लो करेगा बिकॉज ऑफ हाई टेम्परेचर, सो आई कैन से दैट दिस हीट विल फ्लो फ्रॉम ए टू बी. तो यहां पे हो क्या रहा है, व्हेनेवर यू आर कीपिंग टू बॉडीज इन कॉन्टैक्ट, एक बॉडी हीट लूज करेगा, दूसरा बॉडी हीट गेन करेगा, एंड दैट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री, दैट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री. देखो कैलोरीमेट्री में कुछ है नहीं, वहां पर बस यही है कि हीट गेन बाई वन बॉडी इक्वल टू हीट लॉस बाई अनदर बॉडी टिल they will reach to a common temperature, till they will reach to a common temperature. Kaise? Dekho, agar maan lo yahan pe body A is having temperature of 40 degree Celsius, body B having a temperature 20 degree Celsius. To yahan pe ek baat clear hai ki body A temperature ko, sorry, heat ko release karega. There is a loss of heat from body A, and there is, yeah, Rajan saying A to B, Ankit is also saying A to B, very good. And there is a, agar main yahan pe baat karu this example ki, to there is a loss of heat from A to, from body A, and there is a gain of heat in body B, okay, till they will reach at a common temperature. The common temperature, agar maan lo yahan pe after some time, let's assume that this is again body A and this is again body B, you are connecting through a some wire, here this is body A, this is body B, and they reach at a temperature of 30 degree Celsius, here it is also 30 degree Celsius. Ab yahan pe there is no any transfer of heat, there is no any transfer of heat. Why? Because they have reached at a constant temperature or a common temperature. सही बात है ना कि अगर मान लो दो bodies के बीच का same temperature है तो वहाँ पे there is neither loss of heat neither gain of heat between two bodies. Why? Because they have already at a same temperature. Because for flow of heat there should be some difference of temperature. Okay? So now, so this is the principle of calorimetric. Whenever we keep two bodies in contact, one body will lose energy, another body will gain energy till they will reach at a constant temperature. So basically the principle of calorimetry is this one, heat gain equal to heat loss. डेफिनेशन देखो लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है यहाँ पे, क्योंकि देखो बस इतना याद रखो, हीट गेन बाय वन बॉडी इक्वल टू हीट लॉस बाय अनदर बॉडी. अब हीट लॉस कौन करेगा? जिसकी टेम्परेचर ज्यादा होगी. हीट गेन कौन करेगा? जिसकी टेम्परेचर कम होगा. ठीक है, टिल दे विल रीच एट ए फाइनल टेम्परेचर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स अज्यूम दैट वन बॉडी इज हियर हैविंग टेम्परेचर ऑफ टी एल, अनदर बॉडी इज हियर हैविंग टेम्परेचर ऑफ टी एच, एंड आफ्टर कनेक्टिंग दिस टू बॉडीज द कॉमन टेम्परेचर, सपोज after some time they will reach at a common temperature here T and T. This is the common temperature between two bodies after connecting the two bodies. Okay, now let's assume A and B. Here also it is A and B. अब देखो यहाँ पे always remember one thing कि यहाँ पे suppose that T L is less than T H. Okay, तो जो common temperature होगा it should be always more greater than equal to T L. It should not be less than T L. This common temperature TL is more than equal to TL always. Remember that. This is a very important topic. This should be TL, T is always greater than equal to TL, or T is always less than equal to TH. So here I can say that this TL is more than T, T is more than TL, it should be less than TH. This is the first important concept regarding this principle of calorimetry. Ki always the common temperature is more than lowest temperature and it is less than highest temperature. It should not be less than TL, it should not be more than TH. To kabhi bhi agar maan lo hum baat karenge ki there are two bodies here having temperature of dekho yahan pe 20 degree Celsius, this is 40 degree Celsius. To jo common temperature hoga wo kabhi bhi 10 degree nahi hoga, kabhi bhi 45 degree nahi hoga. It should lie only between the 40 and 20. It should only lie between the 20 and 40. Everyone understood what I'm saying? Principle of calorimetry clear ho raha hai ab sabko? Chalo, let me know also. Theek hai? Ab yahan pe there are certain points like whenever we talk about this principle of calorimetry, it should be like body should be in contact or it should be connected through some wire. Theek hai? Wahan pe kaise lagaoge? To wahan pe hum jab bhi baat karenge, to dekho first point to ye hua ki TL is less than T, it should be less than TH. Second point. You have to use this formula mc delta t if body is changing its temperature, that is the amount of heat it is gained by the object or substance, or it is lost by the substance. We have to use this formula where c is the specific heat capacity. Problem karenge to clear hoga bachcho, theek hai, tension mat lo, bilkul load nahi lena, aaram se padhna hai. Ab dekho maan lo if there is a change in state of object, change in state of object. Kaise? Dekho, for example, suppose there is ice here, suppose this is ice, it is kept at 20 degrees Celsius, and the common temperature of ice after the contact between the contact, suppose this our ice is kept in a water having a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. Let's assume that this is there is a water here. Okay, do not take water. Take as a, you will not understand, then you will complicate it now. For now I will change the degree, like example, okay. Suppose this is ice here at minus 10 degree Celsius, and there is another body having temperature of 20 degree Celsius, and we are just keeping in contact through some wire or some physical contact. What will happen? Suppose ki yahan pe the common temperature T equal to, you can say as a 12 degree Celsius. So let's talk about this ice. To yahan pe ice ko dekho, ab agar mai ko minus 12 10 degree Celsius se 12 pe aana hai, in that case this body, suppose this is body A, to body will lose heat. Hoga ki yahan pe body A se jo heat hoga lose karega, ye ice ko milega. In that case how many types of energy this ice required? For example dekho, तो यहां पे आई कैन से दैट माइनस 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट विल रीच टू 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस. तो यहां पे लेट्स टॉक इन द डिटेल. एक्चुअली सपोज दिस इज आइस हियर, दिस इज आइस राइट हैविंग माइनस 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस. यहां से कहां पहुंचेगा ये? इट विल कम टू आइस एट 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस. अगेन यहां से आइस से ही देखो, अब यहां पे अगर तो आप बोलोगे आइस से वाटर में डायरेक्टली चला जाए, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. इट शुड कम फ्रॉम माइनस 10 टू 0, Again, ice should convert into water. I will say that it is converted into water at 0 degree Celsius. Now, from water to it, it will convert into water at, how was it? It was 12 degree Celsius. So, yahan pe there are three phases of heat transformation. Heat transfer. First one is this one. Yahan pe aapne this is Q1, this is Q2, and this is Q3. Hoga. So, yahan pe Q1 equal to, agar main Q net ki baat karu, net amount of heat gain by the ice. Q gain. You can say as a gain, that is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Understood? Ab yahan pe, what is the value of Q1? So, here I can say MC delta T. Understood? That is equal to -0 - -10 plus M into L. Why M into L? We have to use this latent heat. That is because there is a change in state here. Change in state here. Understood my point? So, yahan pe there is a change in state, we have to use this ML plus again MC delta T. But always remember one thing, that here this is in form of solid, this is in form of liquid here. I can say that for this one it is solid, for this one it is liquid. It means the C, it should be 1, it should be Cs, it should be Cl. Means we have to use this specific heat capacity for solid, that is for ice. Here we have to use specific heat capacity for liquid, that is for water. It means the value of both will be different. Okay. So this is the way you have to find the common temperature. Theek hai. Ab dekho, let's talk about the other point, that is heating curve. That is very important, heating curve. Okay, ab what is heating curve? Ab dekho, yahan pe ek baat to clear hai ki agar maan lo koi bhi solid hai to usko agar aap heat de rahe ho to wahan pe kya karega ki wo till melting point wahan pe aayega wo. Let's talk about the example of water. To agar maan lo water is temperature of -20 degree Celsius, theek hai, to wahan pe agar maine, this is 20 degree Celsius, suppose this is ice here. इसको मैंने कुछ heat amount, कुछ amount of heat दिया, ये आएगा यहाँ पे melting point पे. Understood? That is 0 degree Celsius. Again मैंने कुछ amount of heat दिया, तो यहाँ से इसकी जो यहाँ पे ये ice में ही है, no it will convert into, हाँ यहाँ पे ये ice में ही है. Again ये will convert into water at 0 degree Celsius. यहाँ से again मैंने इसको कुछ amount of heat दिया, suppose I am giving a heat of this one, Q amount of heat I am giving, Q1, here I am giving Q2, here I am giving Q3. So, jab Q3 maine diya, to yahan pe suppose that it will reach at a temperature of, so let's take an example of 100 degree Celsius, and at 100 degree Celsius it will be in form of water, it will start boiling. Ab agar maine again maine kuch amount of heat diya, and 100 degree Celsius is the boiling point of water, so it will convert into vapor. So now it will be in form of vapor. Clear ho raha hai? Matlab yahan pe dekho kitne constant temperature wala state hai. This one, this is the first one, I can say that this is constant temperature. Here also it is constant temperature, but baki in all other cases temperature is increasing. Right. So, we can make a graph, that is the graph between temperature and time. That is the graph between temperature and time. Here I can say this is time and this is temperature. Okay. Now, suppose koi ek body le lo, iski temperature 0 degree tha, wahan pe, let us talk about the minus something, yo ki initial temperature. We are talking about the initial temperature, so it will increase in this way. Kab tak? Till its melting point. After melting point, what will happen? It will change its state from here to here. Temperature will be constant. That is, let's take our T1. Temperature is constant. Again, I have provided some amount of heat. In that case, again, this temperature will increase. Till what? Till its boiling point. Ab boiling point pahunch gaya, agar maine uspe phir se amount of heat diya, in that case, what will happen? In that case, its gain state will change. State will change till vapor form. Again yahan pe agar maine diya isko, if I am just providing again energy, again heat, it will convert it into vapor form. So there is a three, this is, assume that this will be T2, this is T1, here it is T1 time, here it is T2 time, this one is T3, this is T4, okay. So this is the graph between the temperature and time, that is called heat, that is called heating curve, it is known as heating curve. अब देखो इसमें बहुत सारी बातें होती है कि अगर मैं बात करूं, देखो मान लो लेट्स अज्यूम दैट फ्यू पॉइंट्स, लेट्स अज्यूम दिस इज पॉइंट ओ, दिस इज पॉइंट ए, दिस इज पॉइंट बी, दिस इज पॉइंट सी, दिस इज पॉइंट डी एंड दिस इज, लेट्स अज्यूम दिस इज पॉइंट ई. तो देखो अगर मैं ओए की बात करूं, इन दैट केस आई कैन से दैट दिस टैन थीटा इट विल गिव द स्लोप, विल गिव द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. व्हाट अबाउट ए बी, इन ए बी केस दिस स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी इट विल बी इनफाइनाइट बिकॉज एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर specific heat capacity will be infinite. Why? Because C equal to Q upon M delta T. If delta T tends to 0, your C tends to infinite. Sorry, it should be infinite. So, for this one AB and CD, specific heat capacity will be infinite. But in all other cases for OA, BC and DE, specific heat capacity we can calculate. That is Q upon delta T, we can say that, okay. Everyone understood this heating curve, because I am moving to the problems that is very important. Okay, fine. So, before that one I will discuss the contest question. So, in the previous contest I asked about this contest, like which one is having the not same unit as other, and the correct answer is joule second, because this is totally different. Electron volt is also a unit of power, kilowatt hour is also, sorry, electron volt is a unit of energy, kilowatt hour is also a unit of energy, watt second is also a unit of energy, but joule second is not unit of energy actually. Okay. So the right answer is D, and the correct answer given by the Ankit. So Ankit, very congratulations, you are getting one atom station. Now the next contest question, it is coming here, it is on this screen here. Okay, everyone try to give the right answer for this problem, because I have already explained you many times about this concept. A certain substance having a mass of 50 gram per mole, when 300 joule of heat is added to the 25 gram of sample of this material, its temperature rises from 25 to 45 degrees Celsius. Okay, calculate thermal capacity, specific heat capacity, molar heat capacity of the sample. Ab batao how you will solve this problem. Here this one is having a mass of 50 gram per mole. What is this given? That is molecular weight of the substance. It is known as molecular weight of substance, that is called 50 gram per mole. Okay, yeah, I'm getting comment from Rajan, that is A option. Ankit is saying C option. Theek hai, ab dekho yahan pe what is given, Q is given 300 joule, so I can say that Q equal to 300 joule. Now heat is added to 25 gram of sample of this material, so and delta T is also given, that is 25 to 45 degrees Celsius. So here I can say delta T equal to, now rather than saying, sorry, it's D, fine. Delta T equal to 45 minus 25, you will get 20 degrees Celsius. Okay. Now, ab yahan pe dekho, Q is given, delta T is given. We have to find the thermal capacity. And what was thermal capacity? It is heat per unit mass, or I can say that Q. It should be Q per unit temperature difference, that is called thermal capacity. So this thermal capacity is Q upon delta T. Okay, so it should be how much? It should be 300 divided by delta T is how much? Delta T is 20 degrees Celsius. So I can say that it should be 15 joule per degree Celsius. Okay, understood everyone. Now in the B part, what we have to calculate? Specific heat capacity. And this specific heat capacity is thermal capacity per unit mass. Why? Because देखो thermal capacity क्या था कि amount of heat required to raise the temperature of m kg of any substance. But for specific heat, amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass. So I can say that specific heat equal to thermal capacity divided by mass. That is 15 divided by what is the mass? Mass is given 50 gram per mole, but it's given 25 gram. So I can say that 15 by 25, it should be how much? But we have to convert into kg also, so it will be 600 joule per kg degree Celsius. Now this is A part, this is B part. इन सी पार्ट मोलर हीट कैपेसिटी. अब देखो यहाँ पे मोलर हीट कैपेसिटी क्या होता है, थर्मल कैपेसिटी पर यूनिट मास, दैट इज कॉल्ड थर्मल कैपेसिटी पर यूनिट मास, सॉरी पर यूनिट मोल. सो आई कैन से दैट मोलर हीट कैपेसिटी दैट इज सी एम इक्वल टू थर्मल कैपेसिटी डिवाइडेड बाई म्यू. एंड हाउ यू विल कैलकुलेट म्यू हियर, देखो अब यहाँ पे म्यू कैसे निकालोगे, म्यू के लिए दिया हुआ दैट इज मोलिकुलर वेट इज गिवन, मास इज गिवन, सो आई कैन से दैट म्यू इक्वल टू 50 अपॉन, सॉरी इट शुड बी 25 अपॉन 50, should be 25 upon 50, that is equal to 0.5. So I can say that now CM, that is the molar heat capacity, equal to thermal capacity is how much, that is 15 joule divided by 0.5, you will get 30 joule per mole per degree Celsius. Okay, understood everyone, problem number one. Okay, I am going to move to next problem, that is a very low temperature, the molar heat capacity of rock salt varies as temperature according to dB relation, that is given C equal to KT upon theta D raised to 3. Okay, and here K is given 2000 joule per mole Kelvin and theta D is given 300 Kelvin. How much heat is required to raise the temperature of 2 mole of rock salt from 10 to 50 Kelvin? Dekho, ab yahan pe which formula you are going to use? Can I say dQ equal to mu C dT? For very small temperature difference, there is a change in heat, that is dq equal to mu specific heat capacity into dt, and here I can say dq equal to mu into, ab dekho yahan pe it's given molar heat capacity that is cm, so I can say that it should be mu k into c. C is how much given, c is given k into t upon theta d raised to 3 dt. I think it should be here also, it should be dt. Why? Because here capital T is here, so you have to take this form into dt. Now you can understand the temperature varies from 10 to 50 Kelvin. So I can say that it varies from 10 to 50 Kelvin, it is varies from 0 to Q. Okay. Now, what is the value of this one dq? I can say that Q equal to mu, you can take common, K also you can take common. Now, upon theta d also you can take common, theta d whole raised to 3, and it should be t raised to 3 dt, that is t4 upon 4 10 to 50 Kelvin. Okay, now ab dekho yahan pe mu is given, that is 2 mole, k is also given, that is 2000 joule per mole Kelvin, theta d is also given, that is 300 Kelvin. T 50 raised to 4 minus 10 raised to 4, I can say that Q equal to how much? Q equal to mu, that is 2 mole into K is how much? K is 2000. Theta D is how much? Theta D is 300 raised to 3, not raised to 4 actually. Now, it should be 50 raised to 4 minus 10 raised to 4 divided by 4. So, you will get finally answer. I am just writing the answer here, that is 231.1 joule, that is the amount of heat required. Okay, now let's take what is the mean molar heat capacity. A mean molar heat capacity kaise nikaloge, that is cm equal to q upon mu delta t, that where mu is the number of moles, q is the amount of heat required. I can say that 231.1 divided by mu is how much, that is 2 into delta t, and delta T is 50 minus 10, so it should be 40. You will get some values here, that is 2.9 joule per mole Kelvin. Okay, now this is the B part. In C part, what is the molar heat capacity at 50 Kelvin? Ab dekho yahan pe there is a relation of C equal to K T upon theta D raised to 3, that is the relation of molar heat capacity. So I can say that at T equal to 50 Kelvin, it should be 50. So I can say C equal to 2000, that is the value of K, into T is how much? T is given 50 Kelvin and theta D is 300. So, it should be 50 upon 300 raised to 3. Okay, you will get some values here, that is 9.26 joule per mole Kelvin. That is 9.26 joule per mole Kelvin. Okay, understood everyone? Fine. I am going to move from problem number 3, that is also very important. In order to save energy, suppose you decide to boil water for your tea by sticking it in a thermal flask. Okay. Suppose you use 1/2 kg of tap water at 20°C and water falls 0.4 m in each sec, and you make 30 sec each minute, neglecting any loss of heat by the flask. Calculate how long must you sec the flask so that the water begin to boil. This has been stopped. Let me open once again. Okay, देखो यहाँ पे. तो यहाँ पे always there is a loss of 0.4 m. तो देयर इज अ लॉस ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. देखो जब भी आप हिलाओगे तो वाटर वहां से निकल रहा है. आई कैन से दैट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी विल कन्वर्ट इनटू हीट एनर्जी, दैट इज एम जी एच. एंड व्हाट इज मास? मास इज गिवन 1/2, सो 0.5 इनटू 10 इनटू 0.4, यू विल गेट सम वैल्यूज हियर, दैट इज 2 जूल. राइट, इट शुड बी 2 जूल. अब यहाँ पे देखो कि यू आर जस्ट मेकिंग 30 सेक्स ईच मिनट. तो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द सेक पर मिनट per second, it should be 30/60, that is 1/2 sec per second. So, dekho, for each sec is it 2 joule. So, for this one I can say that for this sec per second, mechanical energy lost per second should be 2 × 1/2, that is 1 joule per second. It should be 1 joule per second. अब देखो यहाँ पे how much heat is required actually. So heat required to boil water from 20 to 100°C. So I can say that heat required to boil water from heat required from 20°C to 100°C. In that case, I can say the Q equal to how much? Q equal to how much? That is 1/2.5 × up C. Specific heat capacity of the water is given, that is 4200. So I can say this is 4200 × 100 − 20. You will get some values here. That is how much? This should be 168 kg. It should be kilojoule, not kg. Actually, it should be kilojoule. 168 kilojoule. अब यहाँ पे देखो कि कितना मैकेनिकल एनर्जी लॉस्ट हुआ पर सेक के लिए, दैट पर सेकंड, दैट इज 1 joule per second. और यहाँ पे अमाउंट ऑफ हीट कितना चाहिए? 168. तो हाउ मच टाइम यू सेक द फ्लास्क सो दैट वाटर बिगिन टू बॉइल? इन दैट केस आई कैन से दैट कि टाइम रिक्वायर्ड क्यू अपॉन, सपोज दिस वन इज Q1, सो आई कैन से दैट Q/Q1, दैट इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? 168,000 / 1, so it should be 168 times, okay, second. That is called, you can say as a second. Why? Because it is per second. So we have to convert into days, 24 × 60 × 60. Almost you have to convert into 1.94 days. 1.94 days. That is equal to, I can say, 2 days. Almost it is 2 days. Understood everyone? ठीक है, चलो we'll move to the problem number 4. What is given? This also a very important question. The temperature of equal masses of 3 different liquids A, B and C are given 12°C, 19 and 28°C. Just let's talk about the just make a diagram for this A, B and C. And here temperature is how much? Temperature is given, this is A, this is B and this is C. And here temperature is given 12°C. Here it is 19°C. Here it is 28°C. And here the common temperature is given, that is after combining these two bodies, here is 16°C. Here also common temperature is given, that is 23°C. We have to find the common temperature between A and C. What will be the temperature when A and C are mixed? So suppose let's talk about, assume that this is T here. अब कैसे निकालोगे? देखो यहाँ पे एक बात क्लियर है कि अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री आई कैन से दैट हीट लॉस बाय बी इक्वल टू हीट गेन बाय ए. अगर आप ए एंड बी को कॉन्टैक्ट में लेके आ रहे हो तो आई कैन से दैट हीट गेन बाय ए इक्वल टू हीट लॉस्ट बाय बी अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री. एंड हाउ यू कैन फाइंड? and let's assume that this CA is the specific heat capacity for A, this CB is the specific heat capacity for B, and CC is the specific heat capacity for C. But there is nothing given about the relation between the specific heat capacity of A, B and C, and no value is given. In that case, and there is equal masses, so I can say that this is M, this is also M, this is also M. So we have to find the relation between the specific heat capacity of all the three bodies here. Okay, so I can say that suppose that this 16 is given. So let's talk MCA, 16 minus 12, that is equal to MCB, 19 minus 16. Just doing the calculation because I have to cover few more questions here. So I can say that from here we will get the value of CA equal to 3/4 CB. Okay, specific heat capacity of A equal to 3/4 CB. Let's talk about the B and C. In B and C, I can say that heat loss by B equal to heat gain by C. Understood? Because there is a B having a less temperature as compared to body C here. So this C will lose energy and body B will gain energy. In that case, I can say that MCB and common temperature is 23 minus 19, that is equal to MCC, and it should be 28 minus 23. From here, I can say that 4CB equal to 4, it should be 5CC. Okay, ab dekho yahan pe we have already got the relation of CB, that is equal to 4CA upon 3, and we have to find the relation between A and C. Why? Because we have to find the common temperature of between the A and C. So I can say that we have to put the value of CB here. CB equal to how much? 4 into 4CA divided by 3, that is equal to 5CC. Let's talk about the body A and C here. Suppose this is body A, body C. And having this having a temperature of how much? Temperature of 12 degrees Celsius, and this one having a temperature of 28 degrees Celsius. So let's talk, assume that this is T here. So I can say that MCA T minus 12, that is equal to MCB 28 minus T here. And there is a relation between C and CB. Sorry, it should be CC, not CB. So from here, we can find the value of T, that is equal to 20.25 degrees Celsius. Okay, understood everyone? Now, problem number 5, what is given? The reading of thermometer of mass 0.0550 kg, and before that one, we will discuss the next one, that is the problem number 6. It is also a very important question actually. In the industrial process, 10 kg of water per hour is to be heated from 20 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. Okay, to do this, steam at 150 degrees Celsius is passed from a boiler into a copper coil, immersed in a water, the steam condenses in the coil and it is returned to the boiler as water. It is 90 degrees Celsius. How many kg of steam is required per hour? You have to find how many kg of steam is required per hour. Ab dekho yahan pe what is happening? There is a 10 kg of water. Suppose this is a 10 kg of water. Okay, is heated from 20 degrees Celsius to, this is 20 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. To do this, ab dekho yahan pe temperature increase kaise karoge? Heat provide karke. It means you have to just provide something up. This water have to be in contact with some higher temperature. So here we have to put this steam here. Suppose this is a steam here and it is passes through a boiler into copper coil. Okay, that is having a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. Ab dekho yahan pe ek baat hamesha yaad rakho ki jo steam hai yahan pe, ab isko contact mein leke aa rahe hain, to jo common temperature is 80 degrees Celsius. No, sorry, it is coming to the 90 degrees Celsius. Why? Dekho, ab this steam condenses in the coil and it is returned to the boiler as a water, and this common temperature and the temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. Dekho, jab aap 10 kg water ke contact mein steam ko leke aaye, to jo uska temperature 150 degrees Celsius tha, wo kaise aa gaya 90 degree pe aa gaya. In that case, I can say that this steam is losing heat and the water is gaining heat, or the water gain, here there is a gain of what heat, and there it is loss of heat here. Q1, Q1, and both, I can say this would be Q1, this one Q1 and Q2, so I can say Q1 equal to Q2. Why? Because yahan pe dekho heat gain by water equal to heat loss by steam here, but here there is a change in state also. Kaise? Dekho yahan pe steam jo hai wo 150 se 100 degree Celsius pe aayega, again this steam will convert into water and then water will come to the 90 degree Celsius. So I can say that for Q1, I can say Let us talk about the Q1. So, Q1 equal to how much? Q1 equal to M1, that is 10 kg. And what is the specific capacity of water that is given? It is not given, so I can take this one 1, not 1 actually. Okay, actually, there is no calculation here. Fine. Dekho. So, here if I talk about the calories, in case of calorimeter, I can say that it should be 4200. So, here it is Q1 equal to 10 into 4.2 into 1000 kilojoule into delta T, that is the 80 minus 20. Okay. And what about Q2 here? Q2 dekho kaise hoga? Yahan pe 3 phases honge. Pahla kya hoga? Steam kaise aega? 150 to 100. Again, there is a state change. Again, there is a 100 to 90. So, I can say that it should be M into C of vapor. Always remember. Dekho, yahan pe latent heat of steam, you have to take this one, and the specific heat of steam, that is 1 calorie per gram. So, yahan pe calorie ko 4.2 joule mein convert kar lena, theek hai? 1 CV into 150 minus 100. Again, there is a state change, that is M into L, and L is given, that is 540 calorie per gram, theek hai? Plus M into C of water. Ab yahan pe aapko water lena hai, in that, and it is 100 minus 90. Yahan se we can find the value of M, because Q1 is already we have calculated, so you can find the value of M here. Okay, next one, problem number 7. How many gram of ice at this one is needed to cool 200 gram of water from 25 degree Celsius to 10 degree Celsius? Ab dekho yahan pe same kaam aapko karna, there is a water here having a temperature of 25 degree Celsius. Yahan pe 25 degree Celsius aapko leke jana hai, yahan pe 10 degree Celsius mein. Means ki ye kya karega, heat lose karega, and ab ye lose kab karega? जब आप किसी ठंडे ऑब्जेक्ट को कांटेक्ट में लेके आओगे, दैट इज कॉल्ड आइस. तो यहां पे देयर इज आइस हियर, दिस इज वाटर, एंड आइस इज कमिंग टू द -14 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस. तो अगेन देखो, आइस के लिए क्या होगा, आइस पहले कहां पे आएगा, -14 टू 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस. अगेन देयर इज स्टेट चेंज, आफ्टर स्टेट चेंज इट शुड बी कम फ्रॉम 0 टू 10 डिग्री सेल्सियस. समझ में आ रहा है? बट यहां पे डायरेक्टली यू कैन टेक दिस Q1. Suppose this is Q1 and this is Q2 here. Q1 equal to Q2, you can find the value of ice here. Same as the problem number 6. Okay. Now, next one, problem number 8. Again, you have to do same thing. The temperature of 100 gram of water is to be raised from 24 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius by adding some amount of steam here. And because in the previous case, it was ice. In this case, it is a example of steam here, combination of steam and water. Because here, again, I will say that this is 100 gram of water, and temperature is changing from 24 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius. But in this case, you have to provide some amount of heat here. Why? Because here the temperature is increasing. But in case of vapor, this is the in case of vapor, its temperature is decreasing. Why? Dekho, yahan pe, suppose this is a vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. Theek hai? So, yahan pe 100 degrees Celsius jo vapor hai, it will come to the 90 degrees Celsius. Common temperature. So, yahan pe you have to take this one, ki vapor pahle water mein convert hoga, in again water will come to the 90 degree Celsius. It means ML plus MC delta T. This is the amount of heat here, and here it is MC delta T. Both you can equate, you can find the value of M here, because M is already given, C is already given, delta T is given, but in this case L is given, delta T is given, C we know, M we need to find. So, after equating this both, you will get the value of M here. Okay, understood everyone? Now, let us have a summary of today's class. So, in today's class, we discuss about heat of transformation, latent heat, heat of evaporation, heat of sublimation, principle of calorimetry, and problems. So, in today's class, we discuss 7 problems. That those problems are very important. So, please go through once again. My request to all of you is, please go through once again. You will understand how you can find the solution of problem based on the calorimetry. That is very important. Okay, everyone understood today class? Okay, so guys, it's a class practice pack. I just prepared 10 most important problems that is very useful for your JEE and NEET preparation, and for your boards and other competitive exams also. Okay, so for today's good luck, we will meet day after tomorrow. Thank you so much. Take care.